The sun is setting on the sylvan wasteland. The deep purples of twilight overhead, an orange horizon in the distance, while beautiful in the sky, are not reflective of those same colors that paint the landscape below. For hundreds and hundreds of square miles, the land here is tortured and bruised, unrecognizable as the idyllic orchards of Eldath that it once was. Centuries of war magic indiscriminately unleashed for the sole purposes of destruction and death have pulverized and reshaped rock, soil, blood, and bone into an arcane hellscape. Ridges of razor-sharp crystal fall into bogs of acid and fire. Residual currents of magic coax pools of bone and viscera to birth hungering oozes and directionless wandering undead. Crevasses still hidden by illusion fall into lava pools patrolled by untethered and wild elementals. That a war still continues in this god's forsaken place is a testament to the madness of war itself. But continue it does. The coming night reveals the campfires of tens of thousands of soldiers across multiple fronts, still fighting a war seemingly without end. To the west, from deep within the Fallenwood, the Falinari elves send new waves of magical beings and soldiers conscripted from dozens of other worlds to replenish their ranks. To the east, in the walled city atop 6,000-foot granite cliffs, the humans of Falconspire raise their fallen dead, while elite regimens quaff the alchemical draughts that will fortify and twist their bodies into living weapons. Soon, the portals will open for the archmages from each side to return with the coming sunrise to cast more destruction down on this land and begin the cycle anew. No one much thinks about, or cares about, the original inhabitants of this region anymore, much less those who were ripped from their homes to fight in a war that was not their own. The Orchards of Eldath was once a place of peace, beauty, and tranquility, where the land provided all anyone could ever need to nourish the body, the mind, and their spirit. Most of the people who once lived here are long gone, killed or displaced by the atrocities of the war. The land, though, a place where divinity once walked amongst the trees. Even as it enters its own last death throes, the land still provides to those who seek it. Hidden grottos and protected glades dot the abused landscape of the wastelands and offer sanctuary to the weary, the broken, and the lost. It is one of these hidden sanctuaries that comes into our focus. Refuge in the wasteland after centuries of war is no longer enchanted groves of green moss and motes of golden fairy fire. It is found in the passed over places, the places that hold no advantage to soldier, scavenger, or general. This particular marshy hollow is filled with the remains of a petrified forest and pockmarked with bogs fed by rancid springs. Nothing strategic or practical remains for armies on the move. But for those just wanting to survive, it is still their home. Out among these crumbling trees of stone, we find a small, lone figure working diligently with a hammer and chisel, harvesting rock fungus that grows sparsely on the petrified stumps here in the hollow. Bird, will you tell us and introduce us to Tamarind Arborleaf?
Yeah,